So what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. I hope you're having an amazing day. And in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at official MIUI 10.2 global stable update for our Redmi Note 6 Pro. So this just came out like almost 3:30 PM, same times for the Redmi Note 5 Pro too. So I didn't get any kind of time to test the battery life and performance of this ROM. And then again, battery life test just doesn't make sense on YouTube. It really depends on how you use the device, whether it's a secondary phone, if you play PUBG and stuff. So yeah, I'm just not going to do that. But I'm just going to make a quick look of what features you get in this update. So this is not a huge update. Again, as you can see, we were already running MIUI 10. This is just a bit of a performance upgrade and a bit of a UI change. So now the UI feels much more fluid than before. There are no lags or hiccups at all, even in the recent task panel. I mean, it's a Snapdragon 636 device. Still, it was stuttering a bit in the recent task panel, but now it's completely gone. Again, if you take a look at the UI, you get everything from the global beta update in this. Like, literally everything is included. Xiaomi has missed nothing. So for example, if you go to the left, you do get more toggles. So here, says for example, the security ones and all other have been updated. You get much more options over here. Again, if you scroll up, you have the remaining widgets down over here. Very pretty touch by Xiaomi. Again, no lags or stuttering at all over here. It's pretty lightweight. Then again, if you take a closer look at the bottom, the navbar. Now the navbar now completely looks like the stock Android. Yes, it doesn't have any animations due to some optimization purposes maybe, but yeah. It does look at stock Android. Like, this is not overlay and stuff. This is what you get. Now I really think this doesn't suit on MIUI 10 at all. I really loved the MIUI 10 buttons. It really suited it. But now I guess Xiaomi should add a button for the switching of overlays. Again, if you go through the apps and bloatware, bloatware is pretty much the same. You don't get anything new. The share chat and everything stuff has been added by Xiaomi earlier. But if you go through the apps, apps open much more quicker. The AI preloading is a bit more tweaked, I might have to say, but yeah. Apps do open fair bit quicker. But then again, as we are talking about the global beta, yeah, everything has been included. So for example, if you go to the inner tabs of this stuff, such as for example cleaner and stuff, all the UI has been updated. You do get this button which I'm completely seeing new. Wow, I'm just dumb. Then again, you have security scan and all the tabs just updated completely, like the new UI, which is very nice that MIUI 10 was actually available for this thing, but the UI wasn't upgraded to the latest versions. But now you definitely get that. If you scroll down, you have a game booster somewhere over here. I mean, it's now right. It was a huge tab over here. Now it's just app log. Then you have test network, first aid. Yes, this is a global stable, guys. And they have included first aid and test network, which is a first, I might have to say. So I have allowed floating notifications for some apps. Yeah, that's an issue. You have dual apps, a bit of a newer icon for that. Blocklist, WhatsApp cleaner and Facebook cleaner have been also included. Yeah, this packs everything from the global beta, which is extremely nice. Then again, let's just exit security scan and go to the settings app. So let's just hop on to it. If you go to the about phone section, again, as you can see, Android version 8.1. The Pi update beta has been still not in the talks yet, but yeah, Xiaomi is internally testing it, so we might see that soon. But as you can see, MIUI 10.2.1 global, which is the same build that we get on the Redmi Note 5 Pro 3 days earlier, which is again amazing for both of the devices because of their two different generations. But again, pretty much is everything same. You don't get January patch over here. Now scrolling down, nothing has been changed at all. Now I know many of you Redmi Note 5 Pro guys also watch my Redmi Note 6 video, so in my last video I was trying to say that this contrast and colors, this is what you get on the Redmi Note 6 Pro or any kind of Redmi 6 device. So for example, you can increase contrast, standard and all the stuff just like before. But yeah, many of you guys, including me, have a white balance misconfig. So you can easily just change the shade over here according to your choice in Redmi Note 6 Pro, which I would really like to see on the Redmi Note 5. Yeah, I mean, my Redmi Note 5's display is just perfect, but my Redmi Note 5 Pro is a bit messed up. Redmi Note 6 is again a bit cooler side. I mean, as you can see, it tends to be a bit bluer, but yeah, I can just now quickly adjust it over here, which is very nice. Then again, scrolling down, you get practically nothing at all. But if you go to the home screen and recents, you get a newer thing called show suggestions. Now the show suggestions added a lot of stuttering in global beta, like it was unbearable for a 15K device. But as you can see, the available RAM is 2.3 GB, which is a bit better, like 200 MB better than the Redmi Note 5 Pro, which is again great. But there is no lag at stutter, even though if you have opened like 8 different apps, there is no lag at all. If I just go to YouTube, it's still in RAM. And there is still no lag, as you can see, pretty great by Xiaomi. But you do get cleaner, security scan, find apps and manage apps right over here, which is, I mean, you rarely use it, but I guess now you will. Then again, talking about more UI stuff, the system UI has been tweaked a lot. There are no lags and stutters anymore at all. Then again, hopping to the camera, seems to be completely untouched. Now in the Redmi Note 5 Pro, we did see 1080p 60fps recording, but over here, there is nothing like that at all. I mean, Redmi Note 5, the device which is made to just justify the price of Redmi Note 5 Pro, has 4K recording, and now after a year, Redmi Note 5 Pro has a 1080p 60fps recording, and device which is a successor of it just records 1080p 30fps, which is, I don't know what in the world it makes sense for Xiaomi, but yeah, we are not getting 60fps as if yet. And overall, it seems a great upgrade for the Redmi Note 6 Pro, but the notch is still kind of issue with this thing. So for example, I'm just trying to say that if you go to the Play Store maybe, or any kind of third party app, as you can see over top there, there's like a 1 to 2 millimeters remaining over there, and it doesn't go away. Now I do have an easy fix for it. If you guys want me to make a video on it, just comment down Rocker fix it and I will just make it. But yeah, what I'm saying is, let me just compare it to my Poco. Wow, what a build is. I just love my job, and again, it's thanks to you guys. But again, if I just go to YouTube on both of these devices, as you can see, the notch is completely touched on the Poco Phone F1 when as compared to the Redmi Note 6 wasted space, which is same as the Mi 8 series, which is, I mean, I don't know what Xiaomi doing again. But if I just open the same video on both of them and just go to the landscape, I mean, this is extremely hard to show, but let's just go full screen. As you can see, Poco Phone F1 takes a whole advantage of that notch, whereas even on the Redmi Note 6 Pro, turn on full screen mode, just doesn't acquire the notch. Yeah, and still there is a 2 millimeter missing over there. Now, the guys who are upgrading from the Redmi Note 5 Pro might love the Redmi Note 6 Pro, but I just prefer the Poco Phone F1. I mean, the screen's huge, I want the whole thing of it, but yeah. That's pretty much it for the complete update video of the Redmi Note 6 Pro. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you want more videos on this Note 6 Pro, which I'm surely making, like Oxygen OS and stuff, please follow me on Instagram for more info. Again, if you have more questions, feel free to hop in on one of my game streams, and see you guys in the next one. Peace.